Good morning, everyone. This is 287. And to those who are keeping the Sabbath today, I hope you're having a happy and a blessed Sabbath. Now, I was prompted in part to do this video first today in light of ongoing events and issues that individuals are having. So I received an email earlier this morning, and it's just really motivated me to go ahead and put this video out first, because I receive, and my wife, we receive a lot of videos about people who are having serious issues and problems in relationships and other aspects of their life. And every time I hear these emails, these letters, it just drives me straight to foundation. And this is something that we all have to understand and get a grasp of to help guide us into a solid position in our life and what we're going through, so we can minimize that, so we can focus on the Father. Now, I'm going to start this off by saying this. There are too many of us, and I'm meaning a lot of you, there are too many of you who are basing your foundation on what the world sets as a platform on how to live your life and make choices. You have to come off of that foundation unto the Heavenly Father's foundation, because His foundation is a sure foundation. Think about it. His word, what He says and what He has laid out for us, does not change. It is solid. It is immovable. Regardless of what the world does, it stays the same. As far as the foundation, with the solid foundation, everything built on it is stable. Now, if we look at the world's foundation, which too many of you are building your life on, it is unstable at best. And I say that to explain it like this. As the world changes in its ideology, in its ideas, in its thoughts, in its perceptions, in its behaviors, you are forced to change with it, because you're standing on that foundation that the world has laid out. So every time it shifts, you shift. Every time it shifts, you shift. You go back and forth, up and down. The foundation is not solid. And this creates a lot of chaos in your life, in your marriages, in your relationships with your family members, in your jobs, in every aspect, because it's constantly shifting. Understand that. Think about it. It's constantly changing and constantly shifting. And what does the world say? Well, you know, things are going to change, and as things change, we need to change with them. Really? Are you kidding me? The word tells us, stand on the Father's foundation. It changes not. Stand on His foundation and force things around you to change according to what He says. This stabilizes your life. Quit shifting at every turn with the world. This causes you too much chaos. Now, also, because so many of you have built your lives on the world's foundation, you have subsequently built your personal relationships with individuals on these same unstable foundations, and it drives you crazy. It leads to all these broken family relationships, marriages, and so forth. Now, and this is what I'm receiving a lot of feedback on, a lot of situations in marriages. Stop building your relationships and marriages on the world's foundation. You have to initially start, and I'm going to tell you now, for those of you who have just fallen out of relationships, marriages, what have you, start with yourself. You have to stop looking at your bad relationships, past marriages, and all these things, or even the bad marriages you're in. Stop looking at the individual and pointing a finger. If you are not standing on the Heavenly Father's foundation, which in Ephesians 2:20, the Savior tells us, this foundation, well, 2:19, He tells us that this is a foundation built by the apostles and disciples, of which He is the chief cornerstone. Think about this. He said, this is a foundation that is built upon me. I'm the chief cornerstone. I'm the main rock. Remember, he told Peter, upon this rock, I build my church. I build my people. He wasn't talking about building upon Peter. He was speaking of himself. He builds everything upon him. Put your foundation, or put your feet on that foundation first. See, you have to be right before you can get involved with other people and be assured that they're right. If you're unsure of who you are, how are you going to blame someone you get with, marry, develop a family with, and you were never sure of who you were? You have to get yourself on a solid foundation first. And I'm talking about in the Word, because once you do that, you'll have a whole list of guidelines. You have a whole list of do's and don'ts. You have a whole clear, full clear direction of where to go, what to go, and how to get there. You won't accept inadequacy in your life, mediocrity in your life. You won't accept these things in your life. You may acknowledge them, but you will let them be where they are and keep it moving. This is what we have to do. We have to quit accepting mediocre things in our life and think at some point that we, or those things themselves, people, will change. Don't set yourself up on the world's foundation to think that things are going to change. Start off with them right in the first place. If you're right, you will only accept what's right. And that is with a grounded foundation in the Word. See, because if you're grounded in the Word and you understand what He expects of you, you won't expect anything less from someone else, especially in these relationships that lead to children and marriage. Hopefully, marriage first. And this is still, even that's about foundation. If you do things based on His foundation, you will go about doing these things the right way. Ground yourself on the heavenly foundation, and all the other things will come accordingly. You won't accept someone who is not a heavenly loving individual into your life, because you will recognize that they're not grounded. Don't accept them into your life and think you can build them or drag them over to a foundation that they should have already been on before you accept them. It's like going into the den with the lions and not doing right when you go in there and expecting their father to keep the lions from devouring you. He did that for Daniel because Daniel was doing what was right. But if you run into that den and you're not doing what's right, you're liable to be eaten alive. And this is what we do in some of these relationships and stuff. We're not doing what's right, but we go out here and latch on to an individual and we expect them to be right. But why should they be? You're not right, so you don't know how to choose right. You have to know what's right to be with right. And as far as individually, it's the same thing. Even if you're single, build yourself up on the solid foundation of the Father. Let me go to Ephesians 2:20 right quick. And we're going to start with 14. He says, "For He is our peace, who hath made both one and hath broken down the middle wall partition between us, having abolished in His flesh the enmity," or hatred, "even the law and commandments contained in ordinances." Okay, let me comment on that one quick second. Ordinances, laws and ordinances that He got rid of. We don't have to do burnt sacrifices. We don't have to go out here and find a sheep without blemish. All these types of things. The laws and ordinances that Moses and the people of Israel had to do, He knocked those down when He was nailed on the cross, not the Sabbath. That had nothing to do with that. That was established at foundations. We're talking about ordinances and things like that. Now, verse 15, "having abolished the flesh and enmity, even the law of commandments contained in the ordinances, for to make in Himself of twain one new man, so making peace." 16, "and that He might reconcile both unto God in one body by the cross, having slain the enmity thereby, and came and preached to you which were afar off and to them that were nigh. For through him we both have access by one Spirit unto the Father. Through him, by one Spirit, or by one character. See, our character has to match the Savior's character. When the Father looks down and he's looking at his Son, if he doesn't see characters of his Son, that's what Spirit is. It's character. Fruit of the Spirit tells us what character is. If he doesn't see the character of his Son, he sees sin. And verse 19, now therefore, ye are no more strangers and foreigners, but fellow citizens with the saints and of the household of God. In verse 20, and are built upon the foundation of the apostles and prophets, Jesus Christ, Yeshua, himself being the chief cornerstone, in whom all the building fitly framed together groweth unto an holy temple in the Lord, in whom ye also are built together for an habitation of God through the Spirit, or through the character. I'm going to do a video about character, because when people hear the words holy and spirit, they're thinking something totally different. But we're talking about foundation. People, please understand, even if you're in a bad situation in terms of a relationship now, marriage, what have you, get yourself off that world's foundation that's shifting and moving all over the place, that has so much chaos in your life because it's unstable. At minimum, it's unstable. Get on a solid foundation and allow or let the rest of the world do whatever it's going to do. Now, in your relationship or relationships, whatever's going on, you have to get yourself right. And this is where we talk about spiritually separating yourself from someone if necessary. If you have to spiritually separate yourself to do what's right according to the Father's word, do that. See, individuals who are in just as much turmoil and chaos as you, they see you as you see them. So let them see you in a different light. Let them see you spiritually grounded. They can't fight that. They can't argue with that. If they see the Father through you, through that character, they're forced to deal with it one way or the other. They either get on, or they're free, according to the word, to go on. See, you have to allow them to do whatever it is they're going to do. And you have to do right, so you're not held accountable. Be accountable for yourself and do what's right. Stand on the Father's foundation that has been laid for us, solid and sure. So, with that being said, remember, the Heavenly Father doesn't call on us to be successful. He calls on us to be faithful. This is 287. I'm out.